Hi, my name is Desiree, and I'm a piano student at Madison. Well, I started when I was 5. My parents bought me an electron, and then 5 years after that, I started playing piano. So when I was 10, and I played for 10 years after that, off and off, you know, playing other instruments as well. And after that, life got in the way, and I stopped for about another 8 years. Then I started again. That's 5 years. I finished, like, so I'm from Indonesia.
Yeah.
And I had my childhood, and also I grew up there. And I, so my first encounter with music was there. And I finished until grade 8 in Indonesia. And after that, I moved to the Netherlands for my further study and work. So in the beginning, because of, you know, new country and everything, I didn't play, and then ended up like 8 years didn't play at all. And then Netherlands, I started playing again. With, I came to Singapore in February this year, and then I started playing again with the, yeah, and then I started with army with medicine then. So my thing, biggest milestone in my journey is that when I can, you know, perform more and also enjoy performing and performing the repertoire that I've never thought possible before. So for this, well, I'm grateful to all piano teachers that I had during my childhood. But I think I owe my piano teacher, Elena Lipsitz. She was the one who, you know, opened up opportunity for me like 5 years ago when I started again. So she opened up new and new understanding in me and how to, you know, learn and understand music. And she also gave me a lot of opportunity to perform. And one of the achievements is, I think, when I played together with her. So I played a Mozart piano concerto in a music association concert in the Netherlands. And she was, yeah, so I was playing with her together. It definitely impacts my life, like especially in how, like, I connect with people, because music is a universal language, right? And then I see it in my workplace, in my previous workplace. At the time, we wanted to give a birthday present for our late professors, and then we thought, like, oh, maybe we can do a home concert. And so my workplace is not a musical environment, but it turned out that everybody was very musical. So we were forming like an ensemble with my other colleagues and with the supervisor. I actually played together. She played harps and I played the piano. So yeah, music has definitely impacted my life and then how I connect with people. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I think the same way when I came to Singapore as well, there's this music, there's a piano, it's called Piano. It's a piano community. So yeah, so then the first time when I came to Singapore as well, through this piano community that I, you know, had my first friends, and then especially in a new country, you need to have something, right? So music has made it, you know, easier. And especially when you meet new people, and the music can always something that you know, that connect people together. It's really, piano is a very lone instrument, like it's a very lonely instrument, but then if you can share with other people, play with other people, or at least, you know, when you perform and then you feel like you're sharing your music with other people, that makes it worth it. Yeah. At the time, my daughter was still 3 years old, so when I started 5 years ago, yeah, she was still 3 years old. But then she saw me playing and everything, right? And then I just made the music, like, I did the music in our life again. So then she also picked it up, and then she wanted to learn as well. So she started learning when she was 5. So she's been learning for about 3 years. Mm. I also had a chance last time for her very first concert. We actually played together, so I was accompanying her. So I think it was such a special feeling. We have more quality time together, like playing music, like playing piano, and now the youngest one started to, you know, play together as well. He's only 2, but so I think it's also like strengthen our relationship, because we have something that we can share. So I used to play with him like on my lap, and then sometimes when I play together with my daughter, he would just come in and then, you know, squeeze in between us, so everything. And then in the end, everybody was like, oh, okay, and then, you know, just make it up.